riser right in the middle of that for everybody. So I can just put like a line that's going to just show where his eyes are, somewhere about there. And I could check that. That's not bad. And then just above that is the brow line. So you kind of look at where the eyes are and take a guess and see where his brow line is. There's different ways of working. This is just a method that is pretty quick to get something down. You can also do measuring, all that kind of stuff, but so that's where his brow line is somewhere. It's maybe a bit high. So I'm not considering his hair, a head, or a beard or anything like that yet. And then from that brow line to where the nose inserts is halfway. From the brow line to the chin, halfway is that where the nose inserts. So I can just kind of, okay, brow line there. Nose is about there. Then it's just all kind of rough guesses. Not guesses, they're accurate, but it's where the bottom of his nose is going to insert. And then halfway between the chin and that point is the bottom of the bottom lip. So these are all kind of nice little things that you can kind of start with. So the bottom lip, somewhere about there. Which of course is where his beard begins, right? So that'll just give me something to hang features and shapes on, right? So then I can kind of start to block in a bit more. So then I can say, okay, I'm gonna take a measurement just from his brow to where his chin is.
Where you think his chin is.
Yeah, exactly. So the side of his head is kind of there. That's all in shadow. I'm just going to block that in. I can take a big width, like how the big width of his head compares to the, let's say, from. Yeah, it's almost totally here. So, yeah, go like that. So, I'm just trying to get, like, just big stuff in first, right? Because it's all going to get tightened up afterwards. And then. Hairs. Here somewhere. Sides here. This beard comes down here. So I'm really just kind of looking at the light and shadow shapes. So this is all like, I'm thinking of his head also as like a box form, so front plane, side plane.
Mm-hmm. Right. Is it all right to take the pictures?
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. No, sight size would be the canvas right next to him. Or I could do sight size from here. This head, though, would be like this big, because I'd be taking how big it is where I am. And so sight size would be the canvas up there, and then I'd like step back. I'd be like, okay, measuring. I'd actually measure with this, like the width, 1:1, the height, 1:1, and then looking. But that's a good way of training people to look. But it really ties into the model too, right? So, because your training is really about seeing first and then afterwards playing with it. But this is a bit more of a construction method where I'm thinking, okay, this is how a head is built. You know, eyes are halfway, nose are halfway. So these things I know, I can just like, quickly put them in and then adjust the features.
What would be the proportions of thinner and than you are doing on the page?
Proportions of oil
and thinner, like
yeah. Usually, if I'm doing layers, I'll work about 1/3 oil to 2/3 terps or spirits.
Now, because you are dipping here and there, so Do you know how much would
be? Well, this is, I'm only really just alla-prima, so it's just, I'm not going to change my medium. Yeah, it's just terps, it's oil paint, oil with a bit of turpentine in it. Mm-hmm. Like maybe 2/3
so
oil.
Mixed already.
Already mixed, yeah. Okay. And then when I get, later on, when I want to get some brush strokes, I'll move to the glit, which is a gel, so then it will actually hold the brush strokes. Mm-hmm. So I can start now to kind of maybe work from the eyes out. I'm just trying to put in some of these features, like I know the bottom of his nose is about there. I can say that his mustache is kind of dark, so I'll group that with the darks. His top lip. It's kind of a shadow.
Do you squint a lot?
Yeah. Squinting a lot. Squinting lets get rid of all the details. So like, I just want to look at the big masses, right? The big shapes. So obviously the more, I mean, that can work, I want to work fairly quickly because I'm under pressure, right? So, always a guess, it's always guessing, and then the more information you have, the more you can kind of tighten things up and be more, hopefully more accurate. Right?
It looks like him already.
Yeah, I mean, those big, when you see someone from a distance, you're not looking at the shape of their nose or how their eyes, you're looking at the big proportions, right? So that's the idea with that kind of construction method.
What color are you using right now? I know you said it.
This is just burnt umber.
Okay.
Yeah. It's the same color etches that I used for the canvas. Mm-hmm. So the width of his head is about the same as from the bottom of his, the top of his head actually to the bottom of the head. So I can do these kind of big comparisons to make sure the proportions are looking okay. Somewhere here. So you can use burnt umber or red. You could actually use any color, really. It doesn't matter. I'm also thinking also of gesture design. So rather, like his shirt actually comes down like this directly underneath him, but to give a bit more of a sense of sitting back, I just shifted it over, right? So and then, you know, you can do things like alignments, like the corner of his eye lines up with his beard in a certain point. So that's the famous artists, you know, holding their pencil up with it. Knitting needle works well because it's straight. How are you doing for time?
Oh shoot, I forgot to start.
Go 15 minutes. 15?
Go 15 minutes. Thanks.
Yeah, don't ask me.
You're fired.
Thanks. Your hair.
So now I probably should just start on this, some place and just start to refine these things. So the eyes are always a good spot. I mean, working from the center out. That's usually where most of your focus is going to be. So I'm just going to start to refine the shapes a little bit. Then I can look at things like the space between the eyes. There's a certain amount of space in there, which sometimes can. Actually, the shadow shape here on the left kind of sneaks over, hooks up with the shadow shape on the right where that the glue vellum I was talking about. And then there's a shadow that kind of goes down the edge of the nose. And these shapes, doing traces of old master paintings will help you design your shapes better. So if you have an artist that you like, Caravaggio is a good one, Rembrandt, Bouguereau, these are all really good painters to. So this is his nose, the edge of his nose here. Then over here, I'm just going to follow his mustache down to his beard into shadow, and then it kind of comes up. And there's the hollow, there's the zygomatic here, the cheekbone. It's a really nice shape there. Kind of looking at how that lines up with the eye above it, and you know, the space between the edge of the nose and that as well. Head is about here. So, hair here. You can start to get a sense too of his character. It seems like maybe he could be a bit wider. It's more than feeling than anything. So we can do some measuring. I'm just going to measure compare measurements, like say from his nose over to his hair. It's the same as the distance from here to here. So yeah, I could definitely go over some more. This shadow shape on his nose to the edge of the hair is the same as bottom of the lip to middle of the forehead. Down a tiny bit, make it look less scrunched up, I guess.
He is kind of scrunched up for me.
A little bit, yeah. I'm just blocking the whole eye shape by itself, and then there's the kind of other shape that's underneath his eye, the bag of the eye there. It's a big So this burnt umber is a good color for shadows. Burnt umber and white would give you a really good shadow color, a flush shadow color. So using it here very thinly, it'll give me a high chroma color, but it's pretty approximate. Actually, a high chroma shadow is not necessarily a bad thing. Because you can always grade these things down very easily, but it can be very difficult to bring up the chroma, the brightness of the painting. So I always tell my students to kind of err on the side of being a little bit more high chroma, because like I said, it's very easy to grade things down. So this is all shadow down here. Do some more measuring just to big widths to heights. So that should be less than that. Close. That's okay. Must be close to time, huh? Right? 5 minutes? Oh, great. Let's try and show the bit of the top red, actually. Pardon?
What brand are your brushes?
Most of these are badly taken care of Rosemary brand. If you don't know Rosemary, she makes great brushes. She sells them online directly to artists. And the prices will be cheaper than, even with shipping from London, than you get brushes here, and the quality will be better. So I highly recommend.
What series do you like? 276?
276, yeah, that fake, the mongoose hair. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I'm really bad at my brushes, as you can see. So the sables I just destroyed. And the bristles are too hard, so mongoose is pretty good.
What do you use to clean your brushes?
Just turps.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. How you doing, Mario? So with this little brush, I'm just going to go in and kind of indicate a little bit of where his top level would be. Because this bottom lip is quite thin, eh? So. I can start to hit some of the real dark darks, start to build up some of these darks a little bit. Not a bad idea. Then I can start to refine some of the shapes before I put some color in. Maybe think about where the eye would be.
Do you always paint from life?
No, usually through photos, unfortunately. I'd like to paint more from life, but you got to pay models, right?
So. Mm-hmm. So if you paint from a photo, do you work off your iPad or do you print the photo?
Both, yeah. Well, usually off the screen of my computer.
Don't you find it's blue? I just tried that for the first time, two paintings, and it's so much blue it seems to come through.
Yeah, but I'm working with a palette, so I'm always interpreting the color anyways. But the nice thing is you can zoom in and stuff, right? It's a good thing, it's a bad thing. Life is always best, I think, so.
But technology is awesome.
Some So I just use the few minutes that are left here just to kind of refine some of the shapes a bit, and then next sitting we can probably bang in some color.
You like starting or finishing better?
Well, finishing is always like hard, right?
Yeah.
Especially if you only have a certain amount of time. So let's take a break. It's probably pretty close.
Very good.